Mr. Excel podcast, sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1724, exact time to the second via keystroke. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question is sent in by James T. at YouTube. He says, in columns A through D, when he pushes a button, he wants to make the exact time to the second to appear in that cell. They use it to calculate how long a call is. Well, James, this is easy. It's just Ctrl colon or Ctrl shift semicolon. We'll put the current time in. And yeah, it's showing you 422, but if we would format these columns to show time down to the second, of course, it would work. So choose that one, click OK, and then over here, Ctrl shift asterisk, press enter. Oh, I see the problem. Okay, so my shortcut key of Ctrl colon doesn't put in the seconds. You need something to put in the seconds. Well, let's switch over to VBA for that. Alt F11. Let's see, if you want it in your personal macro workbook, we could just put it right here in this module or insert a module. I'm going to put it in the workbook for podcast 1724. So click there, insert module. And let's see, let's call it sub exact time. And it's going to be really, really simple. It's going to be ActiveCell.Value is equal to time. VBA gives us this two system variables, time and date. Time and date will give us the exact time, and it'll do it to the second. Let's just in case the cell is not formatted, we'll say number format is equal to H colon MM colon SS. That'll give us military time. If you wanted kind of normal time, you could go AM, PM, but I'm going to go with the military time. All right, yeah, that's it. We'll switch back to Excel. I'll do Alt F8 so I can assign a shortcut key. So here's our exact time options. I'm going to use T for this. Control T is already table, so you might want to put a Shift T in there or choose something else, something that's easy to hit. Click Cancel. We'll try Control T and put the exact time in. I'll use the arrow key to go over. Control T, Control T, Control T. Yeah, okay, you know what, for James, I bet we could make this easier. I bet we could have it automatically. Of course we could do it. We could have it automatically go over to the right. So we're going to say, let's see, if ActiveCell.Column is less than 4, then we want to go to the right. So ActiveCell.Offset, this is not as confusing as the Excel function offset. This is a VBA. We're going to go down 0 rows and 1 column over, dot select. And then otherwise, if we're already over in column 4, then we want to do cells active cell dot row plus 1 back to column 1 dot select. And if, there we go. All right, so this is kind of the James addendum, because James is only entering data in A through D. So Control T, Control T, Control T. Oops, I missed. Control T, Control T. There we go. So I guess, you know, phone starts to ring, call gets picked up, someone goes on with their question, press Control T again, and then I don't know what the fourth column is, but very easy way now to log that data, and then later on come back and do some sort of analysis with it. All right, well, hey, I want to thank James for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.